Namaste, welcome to Gita's Kitchen. Today we'll see how to make a tasty South Indian veg lunch combo. The menu being beans curry and murugaka sambar. Beans, I mean these French beans. I have chopped them and kept ready. Murugaka refers to these drumsticks. Just cut them into long pieces like this and keep them ready. So, to go in a systematic way, first I have taken rice 1 cup, washed and kept ready. Add the required quantity of water to the rice. Then I have the dal here. I have taken 1/2 cup of tuvar dal, that is pigeon pea lentils. Also added water and a pinch of turmeric powder. One small tip, when you cook rice and dal together, keep the dal in the lower one as a lower container and then the rice on top. You can then cook both together in the pressure cooker. So we'll cook it for 3 whistles and switch it off. Now while the rice and dal are getting done, we can make our beans curry. Curry here refers to a stir fry. For that, first we'll take some oil, a tablespoon of oil in a kadai. Oil is hot, add in the mustard seeds, urad dal, a little bit of hing, 2 dry red chilies. And then this is some moong dal which I had soaked for about 10 minutes and kept. About 2 tablespoons of split yellow moong dal. Add it to this. Just stir it a little bit. Then add the washed and chopped beans also to it. Mix everything well together. Add a little bit of turmeric powder and salt to taste. And just sprinkle a little bit of water for the beans to cook. We'll just cover it and cook till done. Now let's check our beans. See, it is very cooked and the dal is also cooked. And you have nice fluffy dal. Dal should not be mashed. This is the perfect beans. Now to this, finally we'll add some freshly grated coconut to it. Mix it well. Your beans curry is done and ready. The cooker also 2 whistles are over. We'll wait for the 3rd whistle. Meanwhile, we can get our sambar ready. I have transferred the beans into the serving container. 3 whistles are also done. We are just waiting for the pressure to be released. So during that time, we can get ready with the sambar preparations. In the same pan, I just washed it and taken. You can take these drumsticks. And add some tamarind extract to it. You can either soak tamarind and take the extract, or I have taken this tamarind paste. So for 1 teaspoon of tamarind paste, I have added 2 cups of water initially. Later on, we can add more water. To this, we'll add some turmeric powder, salt, and a little bit of hing. So now we'll wait for these drumsticks to cook. And the pressure will also be released by that time. See, the drumsticks are boiled and ready. Today we are going to make a shortcut sambar where we are not going to dry roast any ingredients. You just take about 3 teaspoons of this freshly grated coconut, and we are not going to roast and grind any dhaniya or anything. Just add 1.5 teaspoons of sambar powder to this. This homemade sambar powder or ready-made sambar powder, whatever you have, we'll grind this to a paste and add it to the sambar. This ground masala is now ready. Let's have a look at our pressure cooker also. Now lightly mash and churn this cooked dal. We can add the cooked dal to the boiling sambar. This ground masala paste of coconut and sambar powder we'll add to it. Mix it all very well and allow it to come to a boil once again. I'll just add a few curry leaves to it now. Now we'll do the tempering for the sambar. Take a spoon of oil and heat it. Add some mustard seeds, a few methi seeds, and just one dry red chilli, and pour it on the sambar. So your lovely drumstick sambar is ready, along with beans curry and rice. Now, South Indians are familiar with how we make the sambar, the way we use the drumsticks. But many people who are not Indians are also watching this show. North Indians who are not familiar with South Indian cookery are also watching the show. See, North India, sometimes I've seen they boil the drumstick piece and then just scrape out the inner pulp and use it. But we don't do it like that. Serve the rice and the vegetable at the side. Add some ghee. Now, we generally pour the sambar onto this rice along with the drumstick pieces like this. Generally, we use our fingers to eat. We eat with our hands. That is the traditional way of eating. It's a bit hot. That's why I'm just using the spoon. So, when we eat, we just open this out like this with our fingers, and then we can remove this pulp and eat the pulp of the drumstick, and this outer hard portion is discarded. This is just for those who are not familiar with South Indian cooking. Those of you who are familiar, just ignore what I have told you now. So your lovely, tasty, traditional South Indian veg lunch combo of beans curry and drumstick sambar is now ready. Do try out the recipe, share it with your family and friends, and we'll meet again in another interesting recipe video from Gita's Kitchen. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to Gita's Kitchen and don't forget to tap the bell icon for notification about my latest videos. Thank you.